Meanwhile, the hunt for the new speaker for the 17th Lok Sabha has now begun. A search is underway to find the ideal candidate among the BJP MPs for the most prestigious posts in Parliament. The two leading candidates are Maneka Gandhi and SS Ahluwalia. According to sources, Maneka Gandhi could be made the pro tem speaker, in fact, who administers the oath to the new MPs. Maneka Gandhi, an 8-time Lok Sabha MP, who won from Sultanpur this time, was the former Minister for Women and Child Development in the BJP-led government. Ahluwalia is a 6-time Member of Parliament and former Union Minister and is also seen as a strong contender for the post of Speaker. A 4-term Rajya Sabha member, Ahluwalia won the Lok Sabha polls from Bardhaman Durgapur Lok Sabha seat in West Bengal, and in 2014 he had won from Darjeeling. On to the language war now. The centre has tweaked its controversial 3-language formula clause 2 days after the uproar over its new national education policy draft. Now, students in the states across India can now choose their third language till grade 6 and can even change it later. The sudden climb down came after DMK's resolution against the Hindi imposition. Here's our report.
Days after the Narendra Modi government's draft education document, which spelt out the 3-language policy, created an uproar in non-Hindi speaking states, the centre has made a climb down. The earlier draft released on May 31st said that students in non-Hindi states must include Hindi among the 3 languages. The centre has now issued a revised draft that makes no mention of Hindi. The sudden climb down comes even as the DMK passed a resolution against any imposition of Hindi, asserting that there's no space for Hindi in the blood of Tamil people. Stalin threatened a language stir and said that he's ready to fight a battle to stop the imposition.
Let us say it is the wish of the people from various sections. When they were involved in such things, they should know the sentiments of the people. If they are revising it, it is a good measure. We will welcome it.
Other southern states had also reacted angrily. Former Karnataka Chief Minister Siddaramaiah had launched a scathing attack on the centre, calling the 3-language policy a brutal assault on the states down south.
We have been asking the government of India to give an opportunity to states where non-Hindi-speaking states particularly and take their opinion.
The climb down by the centre was evident, with Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman and Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar posting identical Twitter messages in Tamil, promising a review of the draft.
For political purposes, just casting aspersions against the central government, I don't think it is fair. So far, no decision has been taken as far as the language, Hindi, imposition of Hindi is concerned.
Bureau Report, India Today.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.